Insulin is a common diabetes treatment prescribed to type 1 and type 2 diabetics. Everybody with type 1 diabetes and some people with type 2 diabetes need to inject insulin to help to manage their blood sugar levels. In type 2 diabetes, it's the last resort when other drugs no longer work. But in this video, I will share what your doctor didn't tell you about insulin before prescribing it for managing your type 2 diabetes, as this is so important to know. By the way, if you're new to my channel, I'm a nutritionist and a health coach who's all about providing you with the best science-based health and weight loss advice. So if you're interested in staying healthy and fit, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and click the notification bell, as it helps my videos to get shown to more people. So first, let's look at the conventional medicine approach. You get some diabetes symptoms, you go to see your doctor. Your doctor confirms that you have type 2 diabetes. Your doctor doesn't ask questions to find out why do you have diabetes. Most doctors won't ask you, what did you eat? What is your lifestyle? Are you experiencing a lot of stress? What about your sleep? Do you sleep well? Are you active? You see, all of these things affect your blood glucose levels and your insulin levels, but your doctor doesn't care about any of this. Most doctors and diabetes educators would tell you to keep eating whatever you want, just eat tons of sugar, it's fine, carbs are great for diabetics, just take your medication and you'll be fine, go home. What your doctor cares about is prescribing you with medication, because that's what doctors do. They manage your symptoms with medication. They don't try to help you to get healthy. The diabetic medication helps to manage your diabetes symptoms, which is elevated blood glucose. They say diabetes is a blood sugar issue, but what's behind that blood sugar issue is what comes even before your glucose gets elevated. It's chronically elevated insulin. You get high insulin before high glucose. It's called hyperinsulinemia. So how do you get this hyperinsulinemia, or elevated insulin in other words? Your lifestyle might be promoting high insulin levels. Let's say you snack between meals and your diet consists of high amounts of carbohydrates. This will result in chronically elevated insulin. Each time you eat, you elevate insulin. More frequent eating results in more insulin in your body. And eating carbohydrates does the same. 90 to 100% of the carbohydrates that you eat turn into sugar in your body, and this is always followed by the hormone insulin being released to regulate these blood sugars and try to keep them in the normal range. If you follow this type of lifestyle, over time it leads to insulin resistance, meaning you have 5 to 7 times more insulin, but it's ineffective. Pancreatic beta cells compensate for insulin resistance by hypersecretion of insulin. This extra strain on the beta cells results in beta cells failure, in which the pancreas fails to secrete sufficient insulin, and then a type 2 diabetic needs to be put on insulin. So you have type 2 diabetes, you have high blood sugar, you have high insulin trying to put your blood glucose down, but the high carb diet keeps those sugars so high that your body can't produce enough of insulin to keep it at normal ranges anymore. Your beta cells can't keep up and they fail. When your body loses the ability to produce enough of insulin, your doctor will tell you to keep the same lifestyle and put you on insulin. So instead of removing the root cause of diabetes, they tell you to keep the lifestyle that caused it and take medication to manage the symptoms. Well, not removing the root cause, keeping the high-carb diet that causes diabetes and pretending that it's okay is not a good solution. According to Diabetes UK, a life expectancy is reduced on average by more than 20 years in people with type 1 diabetes and up to 10 years in people with type 2 diabetes. Does it have anything to do with taking insulin? Let's have a look at some studies. The title of one of the studies says, Insulin Use and Increased Risk of Mortality in Type 2 Diabetes, a cohort study. They wanted to compare population-based rates of all-cause mortality and cardiovascular mortality in newly treated patients with type 2 diabetes according to levels of insulin exposure. basically looking at how the dose of insulin affects your likelihood of dying. The groups were as follows: no exposure, reference group, low exposure, 0 to less than 3, moderate exposure, 3 to less than 12, and high exposure, 12 or more. And they looked at the relationship between insulin exposure and all-cause mortality, cardiovascular disease-related mortality, and non-vascular mortality after adjustment for demographics, medications, and comorbidities. Basically meaning that they looked at how the amount of insulin affected their likelihood of death from all-cause mortality, cardiovascular disease, such as heart attacks or stroke mortality, and non-cardiovascular disease-related death. And the average age was 65 years old, and the follow-up was 5.1 years. In total, out of those 12,200 diabetics, 1,443, which is 12%, started insulin, and 2,681, which is 22%, deaths occurred. The highest mortality rates were in the high exposure group, 95 deaths per 1,000 person years, compared with 40 deaths per 1,000 person years in the no exposure group, meaning insulin increases your risk of death, and the more insulin you take, the greater are your chances of dying. Then let's look at the next study. It's mind-blowing. The title of the study says, Insulin Therapy Increases Cardiovascular Risk in Type 2 Diabetes. Insulin therapy increased cardiovascular risk and mortality among type 2 diabetes patients in several recent reported clinical trials. To assess whether this association is causative or coincidental, scientific literature was reviewed. They looked at large-scale outcome trials, meta-analysis, and patient registry studies, as well as basic research on the effects of insulin. Although several old studies provided conflicting results, the majority of large observational studies now show strong dose-dependent association for injected insulin with increased cardiovascular risk and worsening mortality. And again, meaning more insulin, more deaths, and dose-dependent, proving that insulin increases the risk of death, and the more insulin, the higher the risk. And they add, insulin clearly causes weight gain, recurrent hypoglycemia, and other potential adverse effects, including iatrogenic hyperinsulinemia. This over-insulinization with use of injected insulin predisposes to inflammation, atherosclerosis, hypertension, dyslipidemia, heart failure, and arrhythmias. These associations support the findings of large-scale evaluations that strongly suggest that insulin therapy has a poorer short- and long-term safety profile than that found to many other anti-type 2 diabetes therapies. The potential adverse effects of insulin therapy should be taken into account. Then the next study, Insulin Use and Cancer Risk in Patients with Type 2 Diabetes, a systematic review and meta-analysis of observational studies. Findings: using data from more than 1 million people, it was found that new use of insulin or insulin glargine was associated with an increased risk of pancreatic and prostate cancers. Next study, Use of Insulin and Insulin Analogs and Risk of Cancer, Systematic Review and Meta-Analysis of Observational Studies. Results: insulin compared to no insulin significantly increased risk for pancreas, liver, kidney, stomach, and respiratory cancer, and decreased risk for prostate cancer. Did your doctor tell you that insulin significantly increases the risk of death and results in various health complications? I'm sure you were not told any of this, and I believe you have the right to know this. Are there any better treatments that don't cause death? Yes, the one that no one told you about: reducing the amount of carbohydrates that you eat. They forgot to tell you that the most important thing is to lower your carbohydrate intake. If you eat 20 to 50 grams of carbohydrates a day, you drastically reduce the need for insulin until you don't need it at all. After starting a low-carb keto diet, Most type 2 diabetes patients are able to stop all of their medication as they have normal blood glucose levels. Just look at this study with 6 years duration. It showed the effectiveness of the keto diet for treating diabetes. It's safe and it's effective. Speak about this to your doctor. If your current doctor tells you that keto isn't safe and you need to take insulin, find a better doctor. As you reduce your carbs, you have to adjust your medication with the help of your doctor, so make sure you do it safely. All studies that are discussed here, you can find the links and read more in the description of this video. And if you need help and support for managing your type 2 diabetes with your diet, feel free to send me an email because I also coach people online. And if you've enjoyed watching this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. And you can also support my YouTube channel by buying me a coffee or signing up for my Patreon. So thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.